Doksan is the traditional, also come from India, passed to Thailand and all these things. And I find out that it's very practical for what we are doing here. So I find out that it's so come together because the muscle tendon meridian, but they don't understand, when they do, they don't understand the muscle tendon meridian. But I see that this is very important part to get it. It's a vibration of the wooden tool, and this vibration, oftentimes it's the blockages. Wooden, this wooden part, it have the power, wood connecting with the liver control the tendons. And the vibration of the wood, it really will loosen, the vibration of it, it loosens the tendon, and it vibration the tendon and muscle also, and the blood circulation will be improved. So it's, I find out that this is very good. And healthy or not healthy is you have to be, make your tendon, so if you go to the whole body, it's one of the best maintenance. Because tendon, we use them so much. And if you toxin to the whole body, you really are very good maintenance of yourself, okay? And the healthy body involved with the tendons. So if the joint have tendons, or knee or other part have tendon, eventually you affecting all the organ tendons. And the organ tendons started to lose because one tendon problem, they have it. So you're increasing the blood circulation, release the tendon, and relax the muscle, tightening the muscle, and they are increasing the nerve also. You really release the tendon, the nerve, the circulation, and releasing pain is very fast. From nervous system headache, shoulder pain, lower back pain, lumbar pain, thigh pain, calf pain, arm pain. The problem is that our finger are limited, and the tendon in the leg and in the back is too big. Okay, so it's so difficult to just go right to it, and it's so big. And so we end up with using elbow, but some of the places we cannot go in. And that's why the toxin, so all the calf pain, arm pain, elbow pain, okay, and the numbs, and the hamstring is the big muscle, okay, and the bending elbow and all this pain. Lumbar pain also, all the whole lumbar is big tendon, and our finger cannot reach it. So you have the big hammer, and you have the small one. This is the most practical one that use. This one is the one most practical for everything. You're getting the nerve that's stuck in the bone. You angle it right and you hit it enough, vibration, hit it enough, you get the information, but you still have to use the finger to releasing it. Okay? And the hitting is how much you can hit. You're not boom, boom like that. Okay? So you have light, harder, or very hard. So this one in the small spaces and the head, the bone and the head and the tendons. And this one for all the muscle. And this also sometimes you don't want to change, you just use this. Okay, all the tendons. And so usually we're using these two, most of them. Okay? This one is the, we file the name, is called the, it's just like apparatus, a device, a wedge. It's just like a tool between, you have one thing between another one. A wedge, in between. So you between and you get the vibration from here to pass through it, to pass through the tendon or pass through to the muscle or the nerve. And the timing and the way is how you're doing it. So usually we have the three tempo. Slow or fast. That's it. So this one, which hammering the flat one, flattened wood, okay? And we use a lot of this, okay, for everywhere, the whole body, tendon, the whole body. And the bigger one, much more for the muscle, bigger muscle, all around the whole body. And this one, between the two muscles. But sometimes you only use half of it. You do on the muscle here on the side. This one is very hard to get it. So you go to, and some between the bone, between the two bone. But usually you just use ankle on the side. So your timing and your feeling, and you start to hit it, and you get a lot of problem out of it. Okay. This one they said they use for the sacrum and the bone cannot. You only, for example, the nerve here, you cannot do this. You cannot do it directly, but you angle it. You angle it down. You angle it down. You angle it down. You angle it down. You get those things out of it, but you cannot put it rightly on the bone. The end cannot put it right on the sacrum. You only from the side, you get it out. Okay? So that's why the two, when it comes to actually using it, is not the way they said, you know. And we only divide into four positions. One is you laying down face up, and you laying down face down, and you're on the side, and you're sitting. That's all. Okay? That's all you have to remember, the position. Okay? Thank you.